Hi, how are you? Very well. I wish I've been much. Hi, how you doing? Hi, how are you?
I'm good, how are you?
I'm good. Yes!
Thank you.
Since everybody is introducing their wives, I also want to acknowledge my beautiful wife. She's such a pillar. She's who I am today. I wanted to talk about, I was asked to talk about the minerals in Zambia, but for some reason, Chanda stole some of the stuff that I wanted to talk about. I was like, Chanda, I wanted to talk about the colors of Zambia. For some reason, you just stole everything. So if you look on your tables, there's these, whatever they're called. So I'm just gonna talk about the, I'll talk about something else as well. Some 10 facts about Zambia. I'm sure you all know that Zambia is a landlocked, right?
Yeah.
I bet you do. Victoria Falls is double the height of Niagara Falls. Did you know that?
No.
Yeah, actually it is. But before, let me also mention something about Victoria Falls, because this has been a fight between the Zambians and the Zimbabweans. So I want to settle this fight today.
Okay.
How many Zimbabweans do we have in here? Do we have any Zambians? Zimbabweans? Oh, I know Mr. Chanjo is. So we're going to settle this today. So Mr. Chanjo, Victoria Falls, is it Zambia or Zimbabwe?
Zambia.
Victoria Falls, is it Zambian or Zimbabwe? No, we have to settle this. You can't say that. Any other Zimbabwean? We have to settle this today. Victoria Falls. I'm here to tell you that Victoria Falls, we own it. It's all Zambia. Okay, the other fact about Zambia is that the traditional name for Victoria Falls is Mosotuni. I'm sure you all know. For those who are not Zambian, it is actually Mosotuni. The smoke that stands. How many people have been to Victoria Falls? You've been to Victoria Falls? If you were a Zambian and you've never been to Victoria Falls, shame on you. I mean, seriously? Okay, I'll go over that one. Let me go back to my notes. Can you get it? Zambia has a vast minerals of... Zambia has a vast minerals, starting from copper, gold, nickel, magnesium, emerald. We have so many minerals in Zambia. And most importantly, the copper. Copper is the largest, Zambia is the largest producer, the second largest producer of copper in the world. As of 2021, we made 8 billion. I don't know. When I look at this number, I'm just thinking, what am I doing here? I'm supposed to be in Zambia. That's a lot of money. If we talk about vegetation and natural resources, Zambia is home to a great vast of inhabitants, which aptly supports an abundance of couch creatures, great and small, including lions, leopard, elephant, giraffes. Zambia has more water than any other country in Africa. Did you know that? We have more water in Zambia than any other country in Africa. So you should be proud of that. The Luangwa Valley alone is a home to an astonishing 100 species of animals and more than 400 bird species, and are all in amazing density, particularly along the river banks and fertile floodplains. And here is my favorite part. My favorite symbol on our flag is the eagle. The eagle represents the people's ability to rise above the national problems. And not just Zambian problem, but any problem. One thing I'm so proud of my Zambian people is that we are fighters. we don't give up. Most of us came to this country with nothing but a dream, hoping that maybe, just maybe one day we can make it. It's exciting to see a lot of Zambians excelling in so many ways, establishing businesses. You have seen so many businesses that have been presented here today. And most of these people that came here, they came with a dream, but today they have businesses. Kudos to those people who have started business. I'm not naive to think that it's always easy for everyone. Life in America can be challenging at times. Working two jobs, most of us we do, supporting people in Africa. My favorite movie line is from The Lion King. Remember who you are. My encouragement to anyone who is instead of fighting right now, and you think like you are, it's just too high. My encouragement to you is you are, remember who you are and where you came from. It may be difficult right now, but I know there's light at the end of the tunnel. And remember that you are an African. You are a warrior. You are born to withstand any circumstances. Guys, let's go and conquer the world.
Let's go conquer the world! You ready? You've been empowered, right? So go and conquer. Hey, move mountains. Hey, stand in the face of any adversity and know that you are a warrior. At the end of the day, there's nothing. So, we have speeches, we have sponsors, speeches, yes. And then we're gonna dance. Because everything that we're learning, and when you come back to the next one, you have a little bit of knowledge about Zambia, right?
Yes, yes.
When you get excited about, you know, when you know about something, you have that confidence, you have that assurance, like this is the right thing that I'm supporting. Mm-hmm. So it's just where this is coming from, Zambia being here, building a great foundation, and we keep soaring. You understand what I'm saying?
Come on.
So, sir, you have something to say before we can call Uncle Lenny's YouTube channel. Now, he's our president, but now he's going to come as Uncle Lenny, the YouTube. You know what I'm saying? And this is going to be the favorite table. Uncle Lenny.
Uncle Lenny, you're a fan favorite over here, but Not right now. I did just want to say the dance floor was supposed to be a bit longer. I was looking forward to dancing today, but sometimes we have to talk.
Hey, let's go.
And I want the voices to calm down. Let's calm down. Zambians, we have to talk. This Zambian time is getting out of hand. You people are being late. I don't think at this point you even know what time the venue starts. I was here at 6 and I started setting up tables. That's uncalled for in a suit. Huh? Please, no. And it's uncalled. How does my girlfriend's mother look at me setting up lifting chairs in a suit that she helped me get? No. Let's try to stay on schedule. Thank you very much for the suit. Let's try to stay on schedule. Please, let's leave early. I texted some of you. You are saying, I'm there, I'm getting here. That's when you are leaving your house. That's unacceptable. Yeah, that thing is not funny. I see you, it was you. But let's try to get here on time. Time actually matters. You know what I mean? So, as Zambians, I was kind of late also, but I was early enough to set up. So that's what matters. But with that being said, we will call Uncle Lenny, the fan favorite, to come on as Uncle Lenny.
Uncle Lenny is one of our sponsors, as you can see from the poster board.
Hello, thank you so much. I all know by name is Uncle Lenny, the only uncle in town. So it's very important, brothers and sisters, to be here for me now to stand as a sponsor. I cannot do what I'm doing without your help. So I'm sure everyone else has a cell phone. Can I see anyone else who has a cell phone, please? Anyone else who has a cell phone? Check Uncle Lenny. The reason why Uncle Lenny comes in is he has to act as a bridge. I want to stop being only Zambians, but I need to know what is it that is happening in my brother's community. Ghana, Uncle Lenny will be there. Cameroon, Uncle Lenny is there. Whatever business, I'm here to showcase or to highlight every business, every talent. If you have a story to tell, don't forget to call Uncle Lenny. He will show up. And it doesn't matter the distance. It doesn't matter the community. We have to look beyond our boundary to what the Muzungu gave to us. We are all one Zambia, one nation, one country, all Africa. That's the reason why Uncle Lenny will show up. It doesn't matter the church. Uncle Lenny will be there. I'm sure there are people that will attest that Uncle Lenny as well will be showing up. Thank you so much.
Like Uncle Lenny said, it doesn't matter the distance. He will walk there. It doesn't matter. He will walk. It might take him 3 days to get there. Make sure you call Uncle Lenny. He will show up. That's what matters.
Yes, Uncle Lenny's channel. What he was trying to tell you is that you better get your phones and subscribe to his channel. Yes, so you can stay informed, right? Updated what's happening. He's been traveling to DC. Next, you'll be surprised. You'll be just in Paris at the Eiffel Tower. Yes, yes, yes. So thank you so much for that. So we have the president of USC, right? We are going to give the president of USC to just, you know, talk to us. We are grateful that you are here. That is you, sir. Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you very much. Thank you very much. So my name is Adam Avotri, and in the interest of solidarity, I'm going to introduce my wife as well. So I introduce my beautiful wife, Alice. Rotary. Yeah, you can give it up for her. It's okay, give it up for her. Thank you so much. So I am, I'm from Ghana. I'm currently the president of the Ghana Association for 2 more months, and then I pass it on. But recently, I was elected the president of the UAC. By the way, you guys have done a very good job putting this place together. And everybody looks really good. The colors look really good. Thank you. And thank you for the invitation, Uncle Lenny. So Zambia, one nation. I was trying to ask him, how do you say hello? I think it's Bwanji, right? Bwanji! All right. The next time I come, I'll have a longer sentence to speak, okay? Bwanji, okay. Thank you so much, guys. So, the story, the history of Zambia was very profound. Anyone from Africa can fit into that story. Because the history of Ghana is really no different than the history of Zambia. From the struggle to the independence to where we are today. What you can tell, what you get from that history is the fact that we are all one people. Whether you're from Zambia, from Ghana, from Cote d'Ivoire, Nigeria, it doesn't matter where. Our story is exactly the same. He was talking, and if you take Zambia out and you put Ghana in, it's the same story. That is why we have a community called the UAC. UAC is the Union of African Communities. During the scramble for Africa, the one big continent was one people. And it was divided into all these countries by foreign nations, right? Now, we have come a long way and we have been indoctrinated and separated in the mind. It's a very, very deep thing and it's gonna be difficult to go back. But what we can do is to start to think like we were before we were divided, which is we are one people, one Africa, one nation. When you see a brother from Zambia, a sister from Zambia, He or she is your brother. He or she is your sister. When you are Zambian and you meet a Nigerian, that's your brother. That's your sister. When you meet somebody from Ghana, that's your brother. That's your sister. Now, I have to say that the Zambia jollof rice is very good, but the Ghana jollof rice, that's a different story. So when we put jollof rice aside, when you see your brother and you see your sister, you see anyone, any African, just remember that we are one people, we are one nation. And that's why I'm here today. All the different folks from the different countries are here today to let Zambia know that I am your brother from Ghana. My wife is your sister from Ghana. The one from Cameroon is your brother. The one from Nigeria is your brother. The one from Congo is your brother. When you see your brother going through something, it doesn't matter where they are from. If they are African, reach out and help them out. And we also have to remember that we are who we are because we are in the greatest country of the world. This country gives us the opportunity to become what we are. We all came with dreams. And now some of us have businesses. For example, we have a clinic. Uncle Lenny featured us on his YouTube. Can we put together for, give it up for Uncle Lenny. He's done a very good job promoting African businesses. We have a pain clinic, a pain and wellness center in Rexford. And we're open to anyone who wants to get out of pain without opioid, without surgery. So if you are in any kind of pain, please feel free to visit us. If you can't find us, just find Uncle Lenny, you can find us. But my closing remarks are these. As we walk the streets of Pittsburgh, as Africans, remember, we are one people. And I pray to God that one day we will truly unite and become the one Africa that we once were. Thank you very much for the invitation. God bless you guys.
Amen. Wonderful, wonderful, wonderful. And that is beautiful. Uncle Emi, as our president, I mean, we have, and I think I'm going to take this moment to have all the executive members come up front. I think this is the moment right now. We have, you know, when you have great leaders, we have a great leader in our community. He's stepping out, you know, going to different nations, like Mr. Eden just indicated. He's going to Ghana, he's going to the Nigerians, you know, they have meetings, he's showing up and representing us. Something is breaking and something is shifting. And there's something special about having great leaders who are not afraid to lead, who are not afraid to speak up, who are not afraid to show love and show support. So if all the executive members can just, if you can just come in front. So yes, Uncle Emi, our president, Pastor Charity, our vice president.
Come on,
Mrs. Lorena.
Come on, give
our treasurer. Yes. Yes.
Those are our sponsors right there.
So I'm going to stand right here so we can see you. Yes. Yes, Auntie Charity, where are you? Mom Charity, she's outside? Okay, if you can just... All right, Uncle Messiah is gone. He was here earlier. We have our president, Uncle Eni, Chief Mwanja Wantu, the president of Zambian Americans in Pittsburgh. Put your hands together for a fearless bird. Amen. We have Pastor Charity, who is our Vice President. Amen. Give your hands up for Pastor Charity. We have some great leaders. It's a powerful team. I'm not even trying to exaggerate anything. We have an amazing team.
Preach.
Very professional team. It's another different type of a team that we have. We work together. Amen. And we have Auntie Priscilla here, Mrs. Waller as the vice secretary. Amen. Amen. Next, we have Mrs. Miranda, who's one of our sponsors as well. She's the treasurer. Amen. And we have Mrs. Rotelli right there, my sister Monica, who is our vice treasurer. Amen. Amen. And we have Mom here, who's my charity care, who's been helping, you know, coordinating the events, the hospitality. So the idea is we are, you know, still in the inception and forming this. We're going to come up with different departments. And I do believe she's in the first department of hospitality. She's just been stepping up, being the coordinator of this event. Amen. Amen. Hallelujah. And we have one of our trustees. The others are not here. Mr. Chimbelu as well. Thank you so much. And last but not the least, myself, Mrs. Martin, Caroline here, the secretary of Zampids. Amen. Oh, amen. So just put your hands together like you mean it for the amazing team of Zampids. Yes, yes, yes. Thank you. Thank you so much. You can just take your seats and thank you for coming up. Amen.
Amen.
Yes. Mr. Fred from Ghana, thank you for coming. I believe we had acknowledged you at the beginning of the event. You were not here. We just want to acknowledge and say thank you for coming. Thank you for... So this is Mr. Fred who helped with the stuff, right? No. Chief, help me so I don't say the wrong things.
So, Fred, I want you to stand up. I want Fred to stand up. You know, there are people in our community that the community doesn't even know. And this is the man who is always behind, trying to fish out our numbers and making sure we come together. Give it up for Fred from Ghana. You know, these are the people that are making a difference, making sure that we come together as people. Fred, I didn't know him. All of a sudden, I just saw the number coming in. I said, I'm Fred from Ghana. I said, what did I do now? He says, we need to come together. There's a, you know, if we talk about Africa coming together, we shouldn't start from that other side. It has to start within ourselves. And there are people like Fred that have taken up about themselves, making sure that he calls Zambia, he calls Somalia, any number. Him, he calls. He's the secretary for Ghana. Fred, thank you so much for what you're doing. And thank you for everybody.
Thank you, thank you, thank you, everybody. So, we've been going through the sponsors. Before we dance, we have to. I mean, they helped, right? So there's two remaining. Mom, are you ready to come up before I come to you? Okay, so that is Temo African Hair Braiding, one of the sponsors for 2023 Independence Gala. Yeah, so you're gonna see her come later, but she'll be coming as a vice president of Zambia. Right now, she's speaking as a sponsor.
Hello, hello, hello. Temo in the house. We are sponsors because we believe in the vision. Temo Braiding is a household name in Pittsburgh. If you've never been there, like my brother Abraham said, shame on you. As long as you have hair on your head, you need to come to Temo. It's on 124 Brownsville Road. On the outside of Pittsburgh. We've been there for 17 years and we do an amazing job there. At Temo, braiding is a passion. Go Google it. Temo African Hair Braiding. So we are proud sponsors this year. Thank you.
Hey, man, that is beautiful. You can see just by the way she's speaking, that it's really a passion. And with that being said, I'm one of the sponsors as well. So before we come to the dance floor, I'm not gonna pass myself. And so our business is called Steel City Building Maintenance.
I'm the CEO and president. We have been in business for 13 years, close to 13 years. We do commercial and residential cleaning. I'm sure most of you know about Steel City. Some of you have worked for Steel City. We've hired people from different countries, and that makes me proud. So a few days ago, I received a message that really touched me, because you know, as a business owner, sometimes you doubt yourself, sometimes, you know, up and down, right? So I received a message from one of our daughters in the community, and she said, "Auntie, thank you so much for what you did for my dad when he first came to America. He paid our school fees. He fed our family because of the job that you offered him when he was not ready to go and work elsewhere." And that just blessed my heart. And so we continue forging on. We continue as Steel City. Right now, we're not really hiring, but when we're good boss, like Mom Charity said, you'll find us. We have great reviews. It's a passion. Cleaning, high standard of cleaning at an affordable price. Steel City Building Maintenance. Thank you. We are proud to be a sponsor this year, 2023 Independence Day. And with that being said, you can say something before we jump on the dance floor, because we're going to dance tonight.
Oh, okay, okay. Before we get to the amazing moves that I'm about to display for everyone, we would like to give a shout out to the president. He just got here. He missed a speech about Zambian time. The president from Cameroon, if you could stand up, please, and just so we could just give you a lovely round of applause. Thank you so much. We've heard the oil with that for us. Thank you so much, Sam. And with that being said, DJ, you can take it away with the music, as I want to dance. Me, I'm ready.
So you know the song that we have to dance. We're all gonna come and make. You know the circle?
Uh-huh.
Right? The symbol of unity.
Yeah.
Right? So that's the first one you're gonna play. And if you are able to stand, let's make that round circle. We're gonna dance. The dance floor is open!
Ready?
Let's warm up! We're going to do this dance routine called in song by Kunda. Thank you.
Let's go.